case of East Indian lemongrass, it is Simbopogon flexuosus. Do you remember the name? East Indian lemongrass is Simbopogon flexuosus. Okay, and it has a aromatic compound as citral 80%, and we have oil content of 1 to 1.2%. Clear? Simbopogon flexuosus, East Indian lemongrass, whereas the West Indian lemongrass is Simbopogon citratus. You must remember the names and scientific name of different species also. Simbopogon flexuosus is a East Indian lemongrass, whereas Simbopogon citratus is a West Indian lemongrass. Okay, the West Indian lemongrass is also called as American lemongrass. You must also remember the American lemongrass is all nothing but the West Indian lemongrass, Simbopogon citratus. Okay, it has a citral content 1 to 1.2%, same as East Indian lemongrass. Clear? One species which is named by Indian origin, that is Jammu or North Indian lemongrass. Okay, that is Simbopogon pendulus. Clear about the lemongrass species and the three different scientific name of it? East Indian lemongrass, Simbopogon flexuosus. West Indian lemongrass, Simbopogon citratus. North Indian or Jammu lemongrass, Simbopogon pendulus. All these have the oil content of 1 to 1.2%, whereas North Indian lemongrass has around 0.75%. Coming to its importance, lemongrass is originated in India, so you must remember its origin. Lemongrass is originated in India with the chromosome number 2N is equal to 40 for your information. Okay, Simbopogon flexuosus, that is East Indian lemongrass, is also called as Cochin oil. Okay, among the three different species, East Indian, West Indian, and the Jammu, Simbopogon flexuosus, East Indian lemongrass, has the highest oil content and also the best oil content. So the best yielders of lemon oil or a citral oil is East Indian lemongrass, that is Simbopogon flexuosus. Clear? And then other important question that you have to remember is Simbopogon flexuosus or lemongrass, the citral constituent is generally used in the preparation of vitamin A. The artificial manufacturing of vitamin A can be prepared by the citral content. You must remember the vitamin A synthesis artificially, or the vitamin A manufacture, vitamin A artificial synthesis can be done with the help of citral. Okay, can be done with the help of citral. And we have the economical part also. The economical part you have to remember here. In case of lemongrass, the economical part is leaves and shoots. Leaves and shoots are the major source for the citral constituent. Okay, the terpenol constituent, the major source is leaves and shoots. Coming to its major important varieties, few of the important varieties that you have to remember. One is Pragati. Okay, the Pragati is the major one. You must remember that is a clonal selection. Okay, as the name indicates, Pragati has a purple leaf shape and it has a citral constant of 85 to 90%. And then we have Neema, Kaveri, Krishna. Among all these things, you must remember Neema. Okay, because it is through the sib mating one. The sib mating variety in case of lemongrass is Neema. And then the one more variety you have to remember, that is Sugandhi. Okay, that is a lemongrass variety, Sugandhi, which is red stemmed, whereas the purple stemmed is Pragati. Clear? And then we have one more variety, Chiraharita. Okay, and that is also through a, and you must remember the Chiraharita also because it is frost resistant. Chiraharit is a frost resistant, whereas Sugandhi is a red stemmed and Pragati is a purple stem. Okay, other than this, there are two North Indian varieties, North Indian lemongrass varieties, that is North Indian or Jammu, what I was saying, Simbopogon pendulus. One is CKP25, which is an interspecific hybrid, between Simbopogon kashianus into Simbopogon pendulus. Okay, the CKP25 is an interspecific hybrid between Simbopogon kashianus into Simbopogon pendulus. Clear? And there is a one more F2 derivative of the same one, that is CKP38. Okay, CKP38 and CPK25 and CKP38. These two are the interspecific hybrids. They are from, they belongs to North Indian lemongrass. Clear? That is Simbopogon pendulus. These are propagated through seeds and suckers. The commercial method of propagation is through slips. Okay, I mean to say with the vegetative method. The vegetative method is a commercial method. Slips, around 55,000 slips required per hectare. Harvesting is generally done after 9 months. Okay, sorry, after 3 months, that is 90 days. Okay, whereas in case of Simbopogon pendulus, we usually harvest after 90 days. Whereas in case of Simbopogon citratus and flexuosus, it takes around 90 to 100 days. Okay, this is a major important. One more thing you have to remember is Simbopogon kashianus is the one more species which has the geraniol content. if I say about the lemongrass, which are richest source of citral content, right? Whereas Simbopogon kashianus has a major source of geraniol content. Clear? The Simbopogon kashianus has a geraniol content, whereas all other species have citral content. And there was a one question last to last year, probably in 2018, I hope, 18 or 17. The drought prune areas, the variety suitable for drought prune areas, that is Sim Swarna. Do remember the variety name, Sim Swarna, S-W-A-R-N-A. Sim Swarna is a clonal selection variety and it is suitable for drought prune areas. Okay, clonal selection variety that is suitable for drought prune area is Sim Swarna. These are the few varieties that you have to remember now. Sim Swarna, we have to remember. You need to remember Sugandhi, Chiraharit, and then Pragati. Krishna, Kaveri, all these are the lemongrass varieties, and do remember them. And lemongrass is a short day plant. Clear about the lemongrass? This is all you have to remember in case of lemongrass. Coming to the next important grass, lemongrass, Simbopogon species. It has three major species. One is East Indian lemongrass, another one is West Indian lemongrass, another one is Jammu or North Indian lemongrass. East Indian lemongrass is called as Simbopogon flexuosus. West Indian lemongrass is called as Simbopogon citratus. North Indian or Jammu lemongrass is called as Simbopogon pendulus. Okay, all these varieties, all these species have citral as the major constituent, 1 to 1.2%. Clear? Lemongrass originated in India with the 2N of 40. Clear? Among the three different species, Simbopogon flexuosus, that is East Indian lemongrass, is best. It is called as Cochin lemongrass. Lemongrass is used for the synthesis or the manufacturing of artificial vitamin A. Okay, alpha ionones. You can also get confused with the name alpha ionone and beta ionones. The alpha ionones are the one which are used for the preparation of vitamin A. These ionones are extracted from lemongrass species. Okay, coming to the varieties, Pragati, the purple stemmed one, Nima, Kaveri, Krishna, you must remember. And then you must remember Sugandhi, that is also called as OD19. Okay, Sugandhi is also called as OD19, a red stemmed one. Sugandhi is a red stemmed one, whereas Pragati is a purple stemmed one. Then we have two interspecific hybrids from North Indian lemongrass, that is CKP25, another one is CPK38. These two are the crosses between Simbopogon kashianus into Simbopogon pendulus. Clear? Among the different species, kashianus has geraniol content, whereas flexuosus and citratus and pendulus, all these have citral content, whereas kashianus has the citral content. Clear? And then it is harvested after 90 days, propagated through slips, 55,000 slips required. This is what you must remember in case of lemongrass. Then the important another grass is the citronella. Okay, in case of citronella, we have two types of citronella. One is Java citronella, another one is Ceylon citronella. Please do listen carefully because we don't have a presentations. Okay, I can share you my notes afterwards, but you must listen carefully and please add on the points to your original notes. Okay, we have two species in case of citronella. One is Java citronella, another one is Ceylon citronella. Java citronella scientifically Simbopogon winterianus, whereas Ceylon citronella scientifically Simbopogon nardus. Clear? These scientific names makes you so confusion, and in examination just scientific names will make you so confusion. So you must think the questions very question, that means scientific names very carefully. Okay, Java, we'll go ahead. The citronella, it has two species. One is Java citronella and Ceylon citronella. Java citronella scientifically Simbopogon, we have two species in case of citronella. One is Java citronella and Ceylon citronella. Java citronella scientifically Simbopogon winterianus. Okay, whereas Ceylon citronella is Simbopogon nardus. You must remember the names. Java citronella is Simbopogon winterianus. Ceylon citronella is Simbopogon nardus. Chromosome number of citronella is 2N is 20. And the chromosome number of lemongrass was 2N is equal to 40. Okay, lemongrass and citronella both belongs to the family Poaceae. And among the two different species, Java citronella and Ceylon citronella, Java citronella is considered as the best one. Whereas in case of lemongrass, it was Simbopogon flexuosus, East Indian lemongrass, was considered as the best. Here in case of citronella, it is Java citronella is considered as one of the best. Coming to its major varieties, you must remember the variety name. We have Manjusha, okay? We have Mandakini and Manjari. All these rhyming words you can easily remember. Manjusha, Mandakini and Manjari. And then we have Simbio 13, okay? And then we have Simjiva,
and then we have Medini. I repeat, Manjusha, Mandakini, Manjari. Okay, and then we have SimBio13. Okay, and then we have SimJeeva, and then we have Medini. Okay, these are the major one. Among the different varieties here, you must remember one variety, that is SimBio13. Okay, that is SimBio13, which is a Somo clone, and it is the first variety. It is to be said that it is the first plant variety to be bred using the somoclonal variations. What are somoclonal variations? You might be knowing the variations which are absorbed in tissue culture technology, right? So the variety or a plant variety which is first absorbed by a somoclonal variation is SimBio13. Okay, you must remember this, might be asked. Okay, and then we have SimJeeva. SimJeeva is through mutation breeding. Okay, SimJeeva, Medini, Mandakini, Manjusha. Okay, and under these, Manjari is the mutated one. Manjusha, Mandakini, Manjari. Manjari is the mutant one. Clear about the varieties? I repeat once again, that is Manjusha, Mandakini, Manjari, SimBio13, SimJeeva, and then Medini. Clear? And then coming to one interspecific hybrid, that is Jamarosa. Okay, as the name indicates, it is a Jamarosa, an interspecific hybrid cross between Simbopogon nardus variety conflictiforus crossed with Simbopogon jabrancosa. Right? I repeat once again, Jamarosa is an interspecific hybrid cross between Simbopogon nardus variety conflictiforus. Okay, Simbopogon nardus variety conflictiforus crossed with Simbopogon jabrancosa. Clear? This is an interspecific hybrid. Whereas in case of Lemongrass, interspecific hybrid, you must remember them. Here in case of Citronella, we have one interspecific hybrid, that is Jamarosa. Citronella is also propagated through slips. Rooted slips is the right answer for this. And the planting material or proportion that we required is 55,000 plants or 55,000 rooted slips. The harvesting time is 4 to 5 months once again. Here in most of the aromatic oils, the steam distillation is generally followed, you must remember. And steam distillation is generally followed, same in case of Citronella and also lemongrass. Here in case of steam distillation, we get the oil recovery of 1 to 1.2%, same as the lemongrass. Okay, 1 to 1.2%, followed by we have the oil recovery of 1 to 1.2%. Citronellol is the major oil constituent. Remember the name. In case of lemongrass, we had citrol. Here in case of citronella, we have citronellol, LAL. Okay, and then we have geraniol. Okay, citronellol of 32 to 45%, whereas geraniol of 12 to 18%. These are the major oils, and the oil recovery is 1 to 1.2%. Clear? Citronella is originated in Sri Lanka. There are two types of citronella, right? That means in case of Java citronella, Java citronella scientifically Simbopogon nardus, right? So the nardus has two types. One is Simbopogon nardus variety lineal, another one is conflictiforus. This is just for your information. I just told, because in case of interspecific hybrids, I given the parentage of Simbopogon nardus variety conflictiforus, right? Why means the nardus has two types. One is lineal, L-I-N-N-A-E-L, another one is Confertiflorus. Okay, so don't get confused. That is also a type of Simbopogon nardus. Java citronella was introduced to India. Java citronella was introduced to India from Sri Lanka in the year 1959. Just for your information for the additional exams. Okay, these are the important aspects in case of citronella. You must remember, I repeat citronella once again. Simbopogon Winteriana is Java citronella, Simbopogon nardus is a Ceylon citronella, and 2N is equal to 20, Poaceae family. Among these two, Java is the best. Okay, Manjusha, Mandakini, Manjari are the varieties. SimBio13, you must remember, first plant somoclonal variety. SimJeeva, you have to remember, and rooted slips harvested after 90 to 105 days. Citronellol and geraniol are the major constituents. The another important Poaceae family crop is Palmarosa. Okay, here also in case of Palmarosa, we have two types. Simbopogon martini is the scientific name of Palmarosa. Don't get confused with the scientific names. You have to buy at them, and you have to ready with the scientific names. The scientific names should be in the tip of your tongue. The all aromatic crops, especially the confusion in case of these Poaceae family plants, but you must remember them. Okay, Simbopogon martini is Palmarosa. We have two types of Simbopogon martini. Okay, Simbopogon martini variety Motia, Simbopogon martini variety Sophia. Clear? Simpogon Martini variety Motia, Simpogon Martini variety Sophia. Whereas in case of Sophia, which is called as ginger grass oil. Okay. Do remember the name Simpogon Martini variety Motia and Simpogon Martini variety Sophia. Whereas Sophia is called as ginger grass oil. Okay. Palmarosa, the ginger grass oil is Simpogon Martini variety Sophia. 2N is equal to 40, same as lemongrass. Whereas citronella is 2N is equal to 20, half of it. Palmarosa, among the different grass species, Palmarosa is the best base perfumery material. That means it has the richest source of geraniol. Okay, Palmarosa has the richest source of geraniol. So geraniol can be a base for several perfumes. In most of the perfumes, geraniol is the one that is the base. So this is the best base. The best perfumery for any oil is the Palmarosa oil, that is geraniol oil. Okay. If someone asks you about the Rosa oil, the Roche oil, something like that, then don't get confused. It is related to Palmarosa itself. R-U-S-A, R-U-S-H-A, R-O-S-H-A, all these things, Rosa, Rosha, all these things are related to the Palmarosa. The Rosa oil, the Rose oil are said to the Palmarosa oil itself. Okay. And the ginger grass oil is called Simpogon Martini variety Sophia. Coming to the varieties, here also we have several varieties. The worth remembering varieties are Trishna, Tripta. Okay, remember the two varieties, Trishna and Tripta. Okay, and then we have two varieties, Vaishnavi and Harsha. Trishna, Tripta, Vaishnavi, Harsha. All Vaishnavi, Harsha are the synthetic one. Okay, they are produced by the synthetic breeding methods. Okay, Trishna and Tripta are other varieties. You must remember these two. Another important aspect here in case of Palmarosa is most of the grasses are propagated through the vegetative methods, right? They are propagated through rooted slips commercially, whereas Palmarosa is commercially propagated through seeds. This is the differentiating factor. Okay, Palmarosa is commercially propagated through seeds with the seed rate of 2.5 kg per hectare. Okay, harvesting also here in case of Palmarosa, it takes around 6 months. Another important aspect you have to remember here is, whereas in case of citronella and lemongrass, the economical part was the leaves and shoots, right? Here in our case, here in Palmarosa case, it is whole herb. I could call it as whole herb. The inflorescence, the leaves, the shoots and the stalks, all are the economical parts. But the highest amount of the geraniol content is obtained from the inflorescence part. Okay, the highest amount of geraniol content is obtained from the inflorescence part, that is 0.83. Okay, the highest inflorescence among the different parts is geraniol, but the economical uses is the whole herb. Whole herb can be used as a economical part. Okay. Then we have 90%, 95% of the oil is constituted with the geraniol. So the geraniol is the major oil here in case of Simpogon. Again, Simpogon Martini is originated in India. Now you can differentiate lemongrass, then citronella and Palmarosa originated in India, and lemongrass and this one Palmarosa, whereas citronella is originated in Ceylon or Sri Lankan parts. Okay, there are two important varieties also. Please remember the other two important varieties, Sim Harsha. Don't get confused with the Sim varieties. You must make a list of them. Okay, Sim Harsha comes under Palmarosa, whereas Sim Jiva comes under citronella. Clear? Sim Harsha, it belongs to Palmarosa. Okay, this is all about the importance in case of Palmarosa. Okay, next, another important and major grass is, that is the vetiver. It has quite differentiating factors compared to all other three. Okay, even though it is a grass, it belongs to the Poaceae family, but its cultivation, Venku BP, can you please mute? Simpogon, as I was saying, that all other species have the Simpogon genus. Here in case of vetiver, it is vetiver genus. Okay, Vetiveria zizanoides. Clear the scientific name, that is Vetiveria zizanoides, belongs to family Graminae or Poaceae. 2N is equal to 20. Okay, now you have to differentiate, you have to write down, except the citronella and the lemongrass and the Palmarosa, they have 2N is equal to 40, whereas citronella and the vetiver, they have the 2N is equal to 20. This is how we have to differentiate. Okay, once again, the origin of vetiver is India. Okay, basically among different grass family, this vetiver grass was cultivated for the soil conservation purpose. Same, we have one more crop in the plantation, that is cashew, which was introduced for the soil conservation purpose. This was also, the vetiver was grown for the soil conservation purpose. Later on, based on its economical value, based on its roots properties, it was considered as an aromatic crop. Okay, we have two types of vetiver. Okay, once again, we have two types of vetiver. One is the seedling type, another one is non-seeding type. That means one can set the seed, another one cannot set the seed. Okay, the seeding types are generally grown in South India, whereas North Indian types are non-seeding types. North Indian type doesn't set any seed, but it's not so much important because seeds are not an economical part here. The economical parts of this crop is roots. You must differentiate. All other plants had the leaves and herbs as the economical part, whereas vetiver has the economical part of roots. Okay, here the varieties are quite important. You must remember them. Okay, we have Dharani. Dharani means root earth, right? So it can be correlated easily. So Dharani, and then we have Gulabi, then we have Kesari, okay, and then we have Simvriddhi. Clear? Simvriddhi comes under vetiver, Simjeeva comes under citronella, and in case of Palmarosa, it is Simharsha. Simharsha, Simjeeva, Simvriddhi. Okay. Sugandhi it comes under which crop? Sugandhi comes under lemongrass, whereas exactly Sugandhi comes under lemongrass, whereas Sugandha comes under vetiver. Clear? This is how the different thing. Sugandhi is under lemongrass, whereas Sugandha is in case of vetiver. And the differentiating character in case of Sugandha is it is a tetraploid strain. Okay, Sugandha is a tetraploid strain. And what is the differentiating character or important character of Simvriddhi? Simvriddhi is drought tolerant. Okay, most of these Poaceae families, they love water. Okay, they are water loving crops, but this vetiver in case of Simvriddhi, that is drought tolerant, it can be grown in a marginal soil. Then coming to its planting system, okay, planting system or the growth, the roots are the economical plant crops, right? Harvesting is generally done after 10 to 12 months. Okay, you must remember this, harvesting of vetiver grass is done after 10 to 12 months. That is around 1 year. After 1 year, the harvesting of roots are generally done. In case of maximum yield or in case of higher root growth, in Kerala, the harvesting is done in after 18 months. In Kerala, the harvesting is done after 18 months. In generally, the harvesting is done. And you must also remember one more thing. Here in case of vetiver, the distillation time you have to remember. Most of the time it has been asked. The distillation time for North Indian types is lesser when compared to South Indian types. Okay, that you have to remember. North Indian types require around 12 hours for the distillation, whereas the South Indian types require around 72 hours. This is very much important. The distillation time for South Indian vetiver is 72 hours. Okay, and it is distillated through water or steam distillation. Okay, and another important factor is the oil content. The oil content is around 1 to 1.5%. The majority of the oil constituents are vetiverol. Vetiverol has the highest oil constituent, around 65 to 75%. Right? Vetiverol has a oil content of 65 to 75% and 1 to 1.5% oil. This is all about the vetiver, and this is all about the major four grasses. Clear? Go through once today so that you can finalize the things. Simbapogan species, lemongrass, citronella palmarosa, and then we have vetiveria zizanoides, that is vetiver. These are the four species which comes under Poaceae.
Sir, vetiverol oil content?
1 to 1.5%. The whole plant oil has root oil has 1 to 1.5% vetiverol. And the vetiver, among the different oils, vetiverol, vetiveron are the one, right? So the vetiverol has the highest constituent, around 65 to 75%. Okay, the vetiverol constituent is around 65 to 75%. The overall oil quality is around 1 to 1.5. If do remember also, the oil yield is around 15 to 16 kg. Okay, 15 to 16 kg oil yield. If someone asks you about the oil yield in case of vetiver, 15 to 16 kg. But you have to remember the important thing is the duration of harvest and the different varieties here in case of vetiver and the oil constituent. Okay.
Sir, for all these crops, that we followed only steam distillation, huh?
Yeah, yeah, we have steam distillation. We have steam distillation. Okay. In case of herbage, if I say about in general, if you want to remember, any crops where you are distillating, the economical part is herb. Okay, there you can go for steam distillation. Here, in case of vetiver, water distillation can also be done because its economical part is root. Okay, whereas in case of herbage, steam distillation is generally done. The basic principle is when the steam passes through the herbage or to the leaves, the oil glands ruptures and then they are condensed and then they are collected. Here, in case of roots, it can be broken down into small pieces and then can be separated on the specific gravity basis. Coming to the other important, we have seven major aromatic crops we are discussing. The other important aromatic crop is the geranium. Okay, so the geranium, scientifically Pelargonium graveolensis. And one more thing, if you have any doubts, you can please put them in question and answer session. We can discuss in the later part. Okay, the geranium, it's scientifically Pelargonium graveolensis. Okay, remember the scientific name. Geraniaceae family, and it is originated in South Africa. Don't get confused. Geranium is originated in South Africa. 2N is equal to 88. Okay, 2N is equal to 88. Here, geranium is the one major chemical constituent or aromatic compound which is extracted from the geranium. Okay, it is used in the isolation of rhodinols. Don't get confused. Geranium is used in the isolation of rhodinols. Okay, whereas citronella, citral content is used in the isolation of ionones, right? Vitamin A. The same thing here also, the geranium is used in the isolation of rhodinol. The same geranium is also used to extract the rhodinol content from the rose oil also, because rose oil has the major geranium and citronella constituent. Same here also, the rhodinol can be extracted using the geranium oil. We have two types of geranium, that also you have to remember, the two types. One is Algerian type, another one is Bourbon type. Okay, Algerian type is also called as the Tunisian type, whereas Bourbon type is also called as Reunion type. Clear? The Algerian or the Tunisian, whereas the Algerian type is called as the Tunisian type, whereas the Bourbonian type is called as Reunion type. Okay, you must make a code AT. You can remember Algerian and Tunisian, both are same, whereas Bourbonian are Reunion. What are the different differentiating characters between these two? Okay, Algerian or Tunisian one, you must remember this, Algerian or Tunisian are unsuitable for wet condition. What does it mean? They cannot be grown in a wet conditions. Okay, Algerian or Tunisian types cannot be grown in a wet conditions, whereas Bourbonian or Reunion types can be grown in a wet conditions. Okay, Bourbonian and Reunion can be grown in a wet conditions. In most of the parts in India, we cultivate Bourbonian types. Okay, Bourbonian types are generally cultivated. Bourbonian type is also called as Reunion type. Reunion types are suitable for wet conditions, whereas Algerian or Tunisian types, they are not suitable for wet conditions. Coming to the important varieties, you might be knowing Himanti, Kunti, Bipali are the three varieties released by CIMAP Lucknow. Okay, they belong to Bourbonian type, rich in geranium. Himanti, Kunti, Bipali. Okay, other than the Himanti, Kunti, Bipali, you must remember one more new variety, that is Sim Pavan. Okay, Sim Pavan belongs to geranium. It is also through an in vitro selection of somoclonal variation. Okay, Sim Pavan is also through an in vitro selection of somoclonal variation. And then we have one more variety called Sim Narmada. Sim Narmada and Sim Pavan belongs to geranium. Himanti, Kunti, Bipali are the basic varieties which were bred very long back, but these are recent one. Okay, these two are the recent one. I repeat, Sim Pavan and Sim Narmada. Okay, and coming to its propagation, as you must have seen, the crop geranium crop is propagated through the terminal cuttings. The propagation in case of geranium is through terminal cuttings. 20 centimeter length, it should be 8 nodes. It should be the ideal terminal cutting length should be 20 centimeter with 8 nodes. Clear? Coming to the harvesting part. Harvesting is done after 8 months. This you have to remember in all the crops, the duration of the crop, the harvesting is done after 8 months. Okay, and then the basic, the maturity indices in case of harvesting the crop is when the basal leaves turn yellow color. Okay, when the basal leaves turn yellow color, the crop has to be harvested. The oil constituent or a geranial content in an oil is very low, very low. Hence, there are several other crops which are used to extract geranium. Okay, so we majorly depend upon Camarosa to extract the geranium, or rose we extract the geranium. Here in case of geranium, we get a very pure oil but a very low concentration. The concentration of oil which is extracted from the geranium is 0.08 to 0.15%. Okay, and the geranium, among the different oils, geranium and citronella are the major one. Geranium has the highest portion, that is 68 to 75%. Clear about the geranium? These are the major important you have to remember. Geranium, different types, its basic scientific information, and then its varieties and its configuration, okay, propagation material. So remember this, that's more than sufficient.
Sir, will you please tell the oil content?
Yeah, the oil content in case of geranium is 0.08 to 0.15. okay, a very low oil constituent, you can remember on that basis. Geranium oil has a very pure geranial content but a very low oil yielding, 0.08 to 0.15. okay, that's all about the oil content.
Sir, there is two type batai, usko bataiye na ek bar.
Sure, there are two types. One is the Algerian type, and it is also called as Algerian or Tunisian type. Another one is Reunion or Borborian type. Clear? There are two types. One is Algerian or Tunisian type. Another one is Borborian or Reunion type. Algerian or Tunisian types are not suitable for wet conditions, whereas Reunion and Borborian types or Bourbon types are suitable for the wet conditions. That is a major difference. Clear?
Yes, sir.
We'll go. We'll head to the next crop, that is the pachauri.
Can you please tell varieties of Borborian types?
Yeah, Himalti, Kunti, Bipali are the Borborian types. Most of the varieties which are grown in Indian constituent or Indian subcontinent are the Borborian type or Borborian type. Coming to the next important crop, that is the pachauri. The next important crop is pachauri. As the name indicates, the scientific name is Pogostomon pachauri. Okay, that is then. One species that is generally grown in not grown in India. So the basic name it is given is the Pogostomon pachauri, but the crop which is grown in India is Pogostomon hyeniensis, hyeniexhus. okay, hyeniexhus is generally grown in India, that is Pogostomon hyeniexhus is grown in India and it is originated in India. Okay, pachauri, Pogostomon pachauri is generally grown not in India, whereas hyeniexhus is grown in India. 2N=34, belongs to family Lamiaceae or Labiatae. Both are same, belongs to family Lamiaceae or Labiatae. Whereas hyeniexhus is originated in India. Pachauri oil is generally or exclusively used in food flavoring industries. Okay, one important aspect. And another important aspect in case of pachauri is there are no synthetic oils which can match the pachauri oil. That is why pachauri is so much important, because in case of geranium or a geranial oil, we have several substitute crops to compensate it. For example, geranium yields a very low oil, so we go for Palmarosa oil or a rose oil which also has a geranium. Whereas pachauri has a particular oil, the pachaulinol. Okay, it has a particular oil, pachaulinol. It cannot be compensated or it cannot be synthesized artificially. So that is very much important crop. Okay, on that basis it is very much important. Pachaulinol is the economic oil constituent of the plant. It was introduced to India. It was not basically an Indian originated pachauri, Pogostomon pachauri. So it was introduced in India in the year 1942 by Tata Oil Mills. Okay, they have introduced this Pogostomon pachauri by Tata Oil Mills. Okay, another important aspect we have to remember is we have three types. Once again, here in pachauri, every crop we have different types, because based as per the growing habits or as per the acclimatization of the crop. So in case of pachauri, we have three types. One is Jawor type, one is Singapore type, another one is Indonesian type. Okay, Jawor type, I repeat, the Indonesian type and the Singapore type. Okay, among these three, Jawor type is considered as the best one. The best oil yielding pachauri among the crop different varieties is Jawor type. Okay, J-O-H-R-E, Jawor type. Okay, or it is, there are other two like Singapore type and Indonesian type also. Coming to the variety, one variety you have to remember here in case of pachauri is Sim Samarth. Don't get confused. Sim Samarth belongs to pachauri, Sim Pavan belongs to geranium. These are the very confusing questions. It was asked in last year 2017 net, I hope. Sim Samarth, Sim Samarth belongs to Pachauli. The oil constituent of Sim Samarth is 2.55. I repeat, 2.55%. Okay. It is propagated vegetative methods. Okay. Rooted cuttings are the propagating materials of around 10 to 12 centimeter. Okay. Spacing also you have to remember. If you look into a crop, you will come to an overall view of the crop. Pachauli is an herbaceous shrub, so we can go around 60 into 60 centimeter spacing. Crop is harvested after 5 months. Okay, crop is harvested after 5 months. When it has to be harvested, the maturity index is when the crop leaves turns pale green to light brown. Okay, pachaulinol is the major oil constituent, which contains 30 to 40%. Pachaulinol. Okay, the overall oil yield of the plant is around 2.5 to 3.5%. The overall oil yield around 2.5 to 3.5%. This is all about pachauli. Pachauli, Phagostomon pachauli, and Phagostomon hyneaxus belongs to family Lamiaceae or Labiatae. 2N is equal to 34, and it is self-pollinated. There are no synthetic chemicals to replace the pachaulinol. It was introduced to India by Tata Oil Mills. There are 3 varieties: Jawor, Singapore, Indonesia. Jawor are the best one. Sim Samarth, the oil constituent is 2.5%, propagated to stem cuttings, rooted stem cuttings, about 10 to 12 centimeters, and the spacing is 60 centimeters, harvested after 5 months after transplanting, and then the important is harvested after when the leaves turn into pale green or light brown color. Thank you. The next important crop is, and next important, and the next, and you must also remember that, don't get confused if someone say you that Phagostomon, and sometimes they also say that Phagostomon pachauli, the synonym for Phagostomon pachauli is Phagostomon cabellin. Okay, Phagostomon cabellin, cabellin. So cabellin and pachauli both are same. Okay, hyneaxus is not the one, it is Indian originated, whereas pachauli and cabellin both are same. Okay. As I was saying, the pachauli Indian originated. Hyneaxus has a very low oil constituent, 0.5 to 2%, whereas pachauli or cabellin has highest oil percentage. Clear? One more thing. One more variety I left. I hope so. Other than Sim Samarth, you also remember the one more variety, that is Sim Shrestha. Okay, Sim Shrestha, which is raised by Simap Lucknow. Simap Bangalore. You might be knowing that there are the regional stations. This is also very much important in case of medicinal aromatic plantation crops. The institutions and their locations also. There is one regional research station of Simap Lucknow in Bangalore, that is Sim Bangalore, Simap Bella Bangalore. They have released Sim. Then we will go through other two important species, other two aromatic crops, that is mint and osimum. These are the one important one you have to remember. If you do this, the major aromatic crops we have completed, so we can go for the medicinal one in the next hour. Mint has several species, so in general I call them as Minta species. Okay, Minta species, there are several species, so I call them as a Minta species. Belongs to family Lamiaceae or Labiatae once again. Okay, originated in Mediterranean region. Okay, originated in Mediterranean region. Among the different mints, Japanese mint is grown in a larger scale. Okay, among the different mint, Japanese mint is grown in the larger scale, whereas bergamot mint and peppermint are generally grown in USA. Clear? USA has a major producer of peppermint and a spearmint, whereas in the world, Japanese mint are generally grown in larger case. Clear? As I was saying about the bergamot mint, it is originated in Europe. Okay. Coming to the scientific names that you have to remember now. Japanese mint, scientifically Minta arabensis. Okay, Japanese means scientifically Minta arabensis. Okay, it spreads through the rootstocks, or it spreads through the root suckers. Okay, that you have to remember. Another name, another variety is peppermint. Scientific name of the peppermint is, as the name indicates, Minta peperata. Okay, Minta peperata. Another mint is spearmint. The scientific name, as it indicates, Minta spicata. Okay, Minta spicata. Okay, one more mint we have, Minta spearmint is also called as Minta viridis also. Minta spicata and Minta viridis. Okay, one more mint we have, that is Scotch spearmint. The normal spearmint is Minta spicata.
Fourth one, repeat please.
Yeah, we'll repeat all of them once again. We have Minta spicata, that is spearmint. Okay, Mynta spicata is a spearmint. It is also called as Mynta viridis. Spearmint is also called as Mynta spicata or Mynta viridis. Clear? Then we have one more variety, Scotch spearmint. Okay. Scientific name is Mynta cardiaca. Okay. So scientific name of Scotch spearmint is Mynta cardiaca. Clear? Okay. Peppermint we have dealt with arvensis, we have dealt with the Mynta spicata spearmint, we have dealt with the cardiaca, and then we have coming to different varieties. Here varieties, you make a note, you make a clear note of varieties, because every species have different varieties. In case of Japanese mint, okay, in case of Japanese mint, we have major varieties like Himalaya, okay, Himalaya, Kalka and Shivalik. Okay, as the name indicates, these belongs to Japanese mint. Himalaya, Kalka and Shivalik, they belongs to Japanese mint, whereas the peppermint variety you have to remember, that is Kukrail, K-U-K-R-A-I-L, Kukrail, okay, which is developed by Simac, peppermint variety, Kukrail, okay. Himalaya, Kalka, Shivalik are variety belongs to Japanese mint. Along with Himalaya, Kalka, Shivalik, Koshi and Gomti are also the varieties of Japanese mint. Here, Himalaya, Kalka, Shivalik, Koshi, Gomti are the varieties of Japanese mint, whereas the peppermint varieties Kukrai. Okay.
So last two varieties of Japanese mint.
Yeah, Koshi and Gomti. K-O-S-H-I, Koshi and Gomti. G-O-M-I-T-H-I. Okay. Gomti or Gomiti. Then we have one important variety in the bergamot mint. You must remember this variety, very important variety, that is Kiran. The Kiran is the bergamot mint variety. Don't get confused. Kiran is the bergamot mint variety. And the important character of this mint variety is it is bred through the mutation breeding through the gamma irradiation. Okay, mutation breeding through gamma irradiation, and it yields linalool. I just want to be clear that mint species have different mint oil constituent. For example, if I say Japanese mint, it has menthol. If I say peppermint, pepperons or a menthol, all these are major constituents of menthol itself. Okay. But this peppermint, sorry, this bergamot mint variety Kiran, okay, it has the linalool content. Okay. The mint which is the linalool constituent is bergamot mint. Okay. The bergamot mint, the oil constituent is linalool, and the variety is Kiran, bred through gamma irradiation. Coming to the chemical composition, very much important here. Here in case of mint, Japanese mint, Mynta arvensis, okay, it has a chemical constituent of menthol. Menthol, the leaf contain around 0.4 to 0.2%. Okay, sorry, 0.4 to 0.6%. Okay, Japanese mint has a menthol constituent, 0.4 to 0.2%. You must remember this. Whereas in case of Mynta peperita, it also has the menthol constituent. Clear? Japanese mint and peppermint both has the menthol constituent. Okay, whereas bergamot mint, Mynta citrata, right? The bergamot mint, Mynta citrata, as I already told, the chemical constituent of bergamot mint is linalool or linalyl acetate. Okay, bergamot mint or a Mynta citrata, linalool or linalyl acetate. Whereas spearmint, which is called as common spearmint, Mynta spicata, right? This is also very much important, you have to remember. Spearmint, it is also called as common spearmint, right? Mynta spicata, it contains the chemical constituent of caravol. The caravol wielding mint is Mynta spicata. The linalool yielding mint is Mynta citrata, the bergamot mint. Clear? Then coming to the propagation, one more important aspect. All these mints, for example, mint, peperate mint, Japanese mint, spicata, and any mint, they are propagated through stolons or suckers. Okay? They are horizontally propagated. That means they grow horizontally, runner, stolon, suckers. These are the above grown parts, right? So these are the one major propagation material in case of mint. Okay, mints are harvested after 4 months after planting. Okay, when they are harvested, when we see the full bloom stage, when we see the mint starting flowering, we need to harvest them. Okay, at 4 months, that means 100 to 120 days. Okay, there are few varieties in case of peppermint. I told you about mint Kukrail, right? Along with the Kukrail, please add few more varieties in case of peppermint. Sim Madhuras, okay, Sim Indus and Sim Patra. I repeat, Sim Madhuras, Sim Indus and Sim Patra. okay, PATRA, Sim Madurus, Sim Indus and Sim Patra also belongs to peppermint. These are also the peppermint variety. And the special characters you can easily remember. Sim Madurus, as the name indicates, Madhu means sweet, right? So this is sweet smelling peppermint variety. Clear? And then we have Sim Indus, that is also menthol content. And then we have Patra. These are the major varieties, okay? Other than Himalaya, Koshi, Gomti, Shivalik, there is one more Sim variety in case of Japanese mint, that is Sim Sarayu, S-A-R-Y-U, Sarayu, okay? Sim Sarayu belongs to Japanese mint, Sim Madurasa, Sim Indus, Sim Patra belongs to peppermint. Clear? Clear now, this is all about the mint and very much important, these chemical constituents you have to remember, you have to remember the varietal wealth of this crop and then you have to remember the scientific name. If you remember them, that's enough for this. If you have any notes, you can...
Which chemical is present in the spearmint?
Spearmint, as the name indicates, caravone is the one. Okay, I told you, na? Spearmint has common spearmint, it's also called as Mintha spicata. Okay, that is... it has caravone constituent, okay? Caravone, C-A-R-V-O-N. Which is the other crop which yields caravone in spice? Have you heard about dill?
Dill.
Dill also yields a caravone oil, okay? You must correlate the things and you must read so that it makes you easy to remember the things. Clear? Okay. These are about the mint. If you have any questions, you can ask them in question and answer section. Next, coming to the other important and the last aromatic crop, important aromatic crop, that is osimum. We have several aromatic crops. I am dealing with the only the major one, because if you cover them, the others are just, if you remember the scientific name, the chemical constituents, that's enough. Okay. And coming to the other important aromatic crop, that is osimum. Same as case of the mint, here also in case of osimum, we have different species. Okay, we have different species. One is, so we call them as osimum species in general. Okay, we have different species, we'll deal later on. They belong to the family Labiatae or Lamiaceae. Here you have to remember the family of every crop, family and the scientific information for any JRF student, it should be in the tip of your tongue. Okay, if I wake up you at night 12 o'clock also, you need to be able to say this because they are very basic and you must remember them. Okay, other than the scientific name and family, here in case of osimum species, osimum, they are Labiatae or Lamiaceae. One important thing is osimum is broadly classified into two types. You might be knowing the broad classification of osimum. That is osimum basilicum and osimum sanctum. Okay, osimum basilicum and osimum sanctum. What is the major difference between osimum basilicum and osimum sanctum group? As the name indicates, basilicum are the miscellaneous seed one. Whatever you see in the market, they are what you call chia seeds or the seeds which are used for as a coolant. Okay, they belongs to osimum basilicum group. They have the miscellaneous seed coat. Whereas sanctum group, Krishna tulsi or the Rama tulsi, these two tulsi, they have non-miscellaneous type. Clear? Osimum sanctum group are non-miscellaneous, whereas basilicum group are miscellaneous one. Coming to the oil constituent. Osimum sanctum species has the eugenol constituent of around 0.5 to 1%. Sanctum group has a eugenol percent of 0.5 to 1%. It is the oil yield. Whereas osimum gratissimum is another species you might be knowing. Osimum gratissimum, it is also having the eugenol. It is also having 1.5 to 1.5%. So there are two varieties which yield eugenol oil. One is sanctum, another one is gratissimum. Okay. And there is one more variety called osimum viridae. Okay. Species. I could call them as a species. One more species called osimum viridae, V-I-R-I-D-E. It has the oil constituent of thymol. Okay. Osimum viridae has the oil constituent of thymol. Sanctum and gratissimum has the eugenol constituent. There is one more species, very much important species, that is osimum Kilimandricaricum. Okay, K-I-L-I-M-O-N, Kilimandricaricum. Okay, as the name indicates, it has the oil constituent of camphor. Kilimandricaricum has the oil constituent of camphor oil, so it yields the camphor oil. So these are the different oil yielding crops now. Clear? One is Kilimandricaricum, it has the camphor oil yielding. Another one is osimum sanctum, that is eugenol. Another one is osimum gratissimum, that also yields eugenol, and osimum viridae, that yields thymol. Clear? Other than this, we have Osimum canum. Just for your information, Osimum canum, it yields linalool. Okay, please make a note of all these things. Osimum canum yields linalool. Osimum all other species I have told you about. And other than this, we have Osimum americanum also. Osimum americanum, that yields methyl chavicol. Okay. Coming to the varieties now. The varietal wealth is also very much important here. In case of Osimum basilicum species, in case of Osimum basilicum species, we have few varieties. I just list down now. Sim Soumya. Okay. Sim stands for Simap. Simap Soumya. S-O-U-M-Y-A. And then Vikrasuda. Okay. It is an hybrid. These belongs to Osimum basilicum group. Sim Soumya, Vikrasuda, Kusumoham, and Sim Sharada. Right. These four varieties belongs to Osimum basilicum group. I repeat. Sim Soumya, Vikrasuda, Kusumoham, Sim Sharada. Okay. These belongs to basilicum group. The other important group is Osimum sanctum. Okay. Osimum sanctum is basically called as the sacred basil, right? We worship them. The sacred basil, Krishna Tulsi or Rama Tulsi, which one? The one we see, the red one is Krishna Tulsi, one the white one is called Rama Tulsi, right? They belongs to Osimum sanctum group. We have three important varieties in the Osimum sanctum group. Sim Ayu, Sim Angana, Sim Kanchana. Clear? The names I repeat, Sim Ayu, Sim Angana, and Sim Kanchana. These three belongs to Osimum sanctum group. Basilicum group, I repeat, Sim Soumya, Vikrasuda, okay, Kusumohak, Sim Sharada. Okay. Whereas in case of Osimum sanctum, sacred basil group, we have Ayu, Angana, and Kanchana. All this belongs to Sim group. There is one interspecific hybrid. Okay, there is one interspecific hybrid crossed between Osimum gratissimum into Osimum sanctum. Okay, it is crossed between Osimum gratissimum and sanctum, that is Closimum. There is one interspecific hybrid called Closimum crossed between Osimum gratissimum into Osimum sanctum. Clear? As the name indicates, it has close-scented one. As the name indicates, it has a close-scenting one. Clo oil constituent is eugenol, right? So you can easily correlate that. Osimum, Closimum, it's a interspecific hybrid cross between gratissimum into sanctum. It has close-scented oil, that is eugenol. Propagated through seeds, Osimums are propagated through seeds with the seed rate of 200 to 250 grams per hectare. Don't get confused. Same as in case of tomato and other solanaceous, we need a very lower seed rate, 200 to 250 gram per hectare. Crop is harvested after 3 to 4 months. Okay. The crop is harvested after 3 to 4 months. Ready to harvest in 92, that means 3 to 4 days. Other than this, in case of this. Okay. There is one more variety. Please make a note of it. Sim Jyoti. Okay. Sim Jyoti, which belongs to Osimum africanum. Okay. It belongs to Osimum africanum. I have not dealt you about this species, but just remember the name. Sim Jyoti belongs to the species Osimum africanum. Jyoti variety, in case of Osimum, has the lemon-scented. Okay, the lemon-scented one, Jyoti. As the name indicates, lemon-scented, what will be the oil constituent? Citral will be the oil constituent. Okay, Osimum africanum variety Jyoti, lemon-scented, and the oil constituent is citral. And the oil constituent is citral. Clear? This is all about the basics of Osimum species, different varieties. There are still many more varieties and the classification, that is not much more important. Remember the basic classification, two types and the varieties which comes under it and the chemical constituents. Clear? This is all about the major aromatic crops. There are still many more aromatic crops to be covered, but on the year of examination point, those crops you can just read on the books available. The scientific name, family, and their chemical constituent is enough in those crops. Okay.
Sir, would you explain the interspecific hybrid in Tulsi?
Yeah, the interspecific hybrid, as I said you, that is Closimum. Okay, the interspecific hybrid, that is Closimum. Closimum, C-L-O-C-I-U-M, Closimum, crossed between Osimum gratissimum into Osimum sanctum. okay, simum gratissimum crossed with ostimum sanctum. As the name indicates, closimum, it has close-scented oil, that is eugenol. Okay, if you want to substitute the clo oil, eugenol oil, then you can extract the oil from this. Usually this is used for the substitute of the clo oil. Clo oil also eugenol, right? It requires a very higher level of precision in forming or in extracting the oil also. Very low oil yield clo. Whereas this one, closimum, you can harvest in hardly 3 to 4 months, where clo required around 7 to 8 years for the first growth, right? And also annually once in a year. Whereas this closimums, they can be grown for 3 to 4 months, and the amount of oil yielding will be also higher. So these are generally used as substitute to the clo oil, eugenol oil. Clear about the aromatic crops? Any doubts in aromatic crops? I can just see them in the question and answer session.
Sir, what is the major the difference between species and the cultivars, sir?
Sorry, come again.
Species and the cultivars means what, sir? What is the difference? What is between species and what is the cultivars?
See, if I want to say about the cultivar species and varieties, cultivars are the one which are generally grown using the species. For example, if I say one species, Osimum sanctum, it is a general type of a crop. Okay, if I say a scientific name, it is a general type of a crop. The varieties are the cultivars which are usually derived from these. They belong to those crops. For example, varieties are generally bred one, right? Whereas cultivars are generally grown in the farming community, which are generally made into popular. Whereas varieties are the bred one, which doesn't have any parentage. That is the difference between variety and hybrid, right? Whereas in case of species and cultivar, cultivars are which are not generally. That means the species are the one which are not generally bred or without any human interference. They are generally in this nature itself. Once you take out them and then you go for making them popular and then cultivating, then it becomes a cultivar. For example, if I say Osimum sanctum is a cultivar, so the varieties are a cultivars which comes under them. They are the varieties and the cultivars. Sorry, you don't have.
Hello, sir.
Yeah. Logish.
Sir, in geranium, geranial oil is used to extract what you said
rodinol.
Rodinol. What is the use of that, sir?
The rodinol is a, it is used generally used in case of high grade perfumery. I just don't want to say that it becomes an additional information. Rodinols are generally used in any high grade perfumeries as a base material. Okay, for example, if you say the lavender oil, they are used in a very minute oil, and then you have to enhance the smell of your perfume, then they use the geranial oil. So these geranials are used in the extraction of rodinols. They are the base material for the high grade perfumery industry. Clear?
Okay, sir. Sir, Simbopogon cautionis is what principle it is having, sir?
Sorry, come again, please.
Simbopogon cautionis, it is having what kind of principle, sir?
Am I audible now? Is it clear?
Yes, sir, you are audible, sir.
Yes, sir, talking about Simbopogon something cautionis, sir.
Cautionis, what principle it is having, sir?
Yeah, here I can see the question. Simbopogon cautionis, geranial constituent. It's not the citral, it is geranial.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
You are the one, right? It has been asked in the question and answer session. Simbopogon cautionis, geranial of
geranium. Yes, sir.
If I am not the set, I am sorry for that. Simbopogon cautionis as geranium constituent. PPT not visible. I am so sorry. We don't have a PPT today. North Indian type vetiver distillation time, sir. Yeah. North Indian type vetiver has the distillation time of around. What is the distillation time? I have told you. It's very much important. Yeah. North Indian types. Sorry, the South Indian types have the longer time, right? That is 72 hours. North Indian types can go for 12 to 14 hours.
12 hours, sir.
Yeah, 12 to 14 hours. Okay, then Simap Lucknow, okay. The smell of Osimum is due to, it depends upon the different species. Abdullah, it depends upon the different species. If you are going for Sanctum, it has a different oil. If you are going for Basilicum group, it has different oil. I have differentiated it.
So, which type of vetiver not set a seed in North Indian
country? As you are saying, South Indian type set the seeds, whereas North Indian types doesn't set the seeds. They are non-seeding type. North Indian types are non-seeding type.
Yes.
Okay. Then, sir, in which aromatic crop order increase upon storage? If you give me the options, then Samantha, a nice one. If you give me the option, then I can go for the answer. Because there are several oils which upon aging they increase oil. For example, Davana oil also it has, then geranium oil also it has. So if you give the options, if you have read it somewhere else, then you please give the options also, so we can clearly go through it. Samantha T.R. Okay.
Sir, I don't.
Then, I will look into it. If I get any particular answer for this, I will forward you guys. Sir, okay, which sir. Aromatic order increases upon storage? Yeah, there are two more oils also, but on particular on the option basis, we can select the answer. Palmarosa has two varieties known, sir, Krishna and Tripta. Tripta, another one is Tripta. Okay, sir, for soil binding, which vetiver type is used? For soil binding, vetiver is generally used for a soil binding itself. Okay, it's not about the types. Vetiver is generally used for a soil binding. If you have read it somewhere else, you can please send me the options also. You can look into it. Okay, vetiver is generally used for a soil binding because of the long roots. Clear? We can go for the medicinal sector.
Yes, sir.